won't explain to you another way that ketamine may be working for patients with chronic pain, and that is the functional mechanism. There's something called the default mode network in the brain, which you may have heard of. This portion of the brain is responsible for thinking about the past, the future, rumination, these reoccurring thoughts that no longer serve us or help us in our lives. So sometimes when we have pain, it's not only the pain that causes mental anguish, but it's the suffering associated with that pain. So I had spoken earlier about the difference between pain and suffering. When a person has chronic pain, they also have anxiety, loneliness, regret, and a host of other emotions and feelings associated with the chronic pain. Ketamine seems to go into the central nervous system and temporarily block activity of the default mode network. And by blocking activity of the default mode network, you can actually extinguish those stories or that mental anguish or suffering that really doesn't serve you. From a functional mechanism, ketamine can temporarily disrupt that activity, which will in turn reduce the suffering associated with the chronic pain. What do you think? If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.